got you.
So, Dessa.
Sims.
What do you got to say? Week 5, week 6, week 7.
It's definitely between week 3 and 9, for sure.
Absolutely. Time is not real. It's a flat circle by a Buick, asked Matthew McConaughey. we are again, Doomtree TV. We're doing it one more week till we get bored of it.
Oh, I thought you were announcing right now that we were doing one more week. I was like, yo, send somebody an email, dude.
Yeah, last week ever. Enjoy while you got it, babies.
Week the best week.
That's right. What do we got coming up this week, Dessa?
We got some big stuff. We've already had some big stuff. We got a brand new video, Trap House, from Sophia Aris and Laserbeak.
Yes.
What else do we have, Sims?
We had a brand new Shredders video this week, which is insane and upsetting and kind of unnerving to see how similar I look to dogs.
like there's no...
I just always assumed I looked like every white guy because everyone's like, you look like that guy. And like, yeah, I do because I look like every white guy. But didn't realize I also look like every dog too. So
it's nice. Pretty sweet. It's
one
a pretty
thing that's
sweet.
Nice is I look like everything. what else happened this week? Oh, new band.
Brand new.
Laserbeak, Jeff Allen from Plastic Constellations, plus a couple other great homies had a band called... it's called Dope Walker. They were going to call it Old Homies to begin with, which I thought was an awesome name, but they called it Dope Walker.
And I kind of like Dope. Well, I mean, Laserbeak leans into those kinds of names pretty hard.
I like Dope Walker. It's an awesome name. It's very sweet. But yeah. Anyway, what else? What do you show Force Majeure?
That was a Thursday night. Little ditty. It happens right here, literally where I'm standing, in this shirt sometimes. Mm-hmm. And some poetry readings, some music and stuff, Instagram live.
Yeah.
Hanging out, doing the thing.
How many responses to the question, how are you doing, have ended in hanging in this
week? I know. Who was it? Was it Sadie? Like, somebody was just like, all of adulthood is just a volley of like, sorry for the late reply. Like, that's it. You know, that's what it boils down to.
Sorry for the late reply. How you hanging in? Hanging tough. Yeah.
You know, do you ever do the thing where you realize that you've started emails the same way for 3 years and you have to remember, like, who you've opened with that way before?
You know what I've been doing lately is just hitting because on Gmail, they have like a, you know, like, you can just reply like this, like suggested prompts at the bottom.
Yeah, you just do that now. Just
hit those. Okay, sounds great. That sounds like we should do this. And then at that point, boom, 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 boom. And then just let the thing compose the email for me.
Totally. Make big business decisions that way. It's like reading tea leaves, except for with the IA technology provided by a super firm.
That's right. Well, Doomtree TV, week 6. We're back here one more time. Enjoy this next little segment of amazingness. I can't wait for you to see this decibit bit. All right.
Essentially soft as that.
It's the grand opening.
It's like one big family, you know.
One big black leather.
An easy way to say, oh, it's so good.
Huh. I made $160 in just one week!
Oh, hello. You know, the hardest thing about painting is the first stroke. Shall we?
And stuffed them so with rich Hormel chili.
Absolutely amazing.
That's a darling. Give me a smile. Come on. Come on. Come on.
That's over 60 minutes of music you and your family will enjoy for years to come. But wait, order in the next 10 minutes and we'll include as our special gift to you 6 or 7 very sharp knives, 2 kinds of staples, an autographed photo of the world's oldest baby, a genuine Austrian beaver skull, Terpenoid, the Knight Rider action activity book. Can you help Kate get from Knight Industries to save Michael in the abandoned munitions factory? There's only one way to find out. Call now.
Root. It's
joined now by 2 members of the Doomtree Collective, a hip-hop group from Minneapolis, who are geared up for the release of their first official album. POS is coming to us from his mother's basement in Minneapolis. Thanks for being here.
Nice to be here, Chuck. Thanks.
And Sims has been kind enough to take time out from his vacation to speak with us via satellite.
It's a pleasure, Chuck. Nice to be here.
Now, POS, tell me a little bit about the new album.
July 29th, we got the first Doomtree crew record coming out. We're all really excited.
And you'll be having some sort of party to commemorate the occasion?
Yeah, we're really excited. We're going to be celebrating its release on August 1st at First Avenue. That show is going to have I Self Divine and Kill the Vultures. We're real pleased to have them. You should come down. It's going to be a good time.
Great. Well, hopefully you'll be able to get away for a few days and come out to the Vineyard with Susan and me.
But of course, Chuck.
Percussion work on that done by...
Well, I've got a question, kids. What kinds of things do you see at the park?
Shoplifting.
Tax evasion.
Drug charges.
Adoption.
Treason.
Personal injury.
Sexual predation.
Hey, yo. First of all, we want to thank God.
Like my mother was saying, I cry all the time.
Awesome.
Where are we going?
My cousin, just exactly what she deserves.
Just wake up, the beat's playing.
They work and some of them live in a rented house near Uptown. They help each other produce CDs, trying to copy the success of Minneapolis rap group Atmosphere.
I have genital herpes.
And I don't. And we aim to keep it that way.
Fuck yeah!
Roamer. These tat. Terrorize Uptown here, and they've been giving me the tour all this weekend.
Well, so what's up? What's your name?
Monique.
My name's Prince Vince.
Let me ask you something. Who's the freshest DJ MC crew around?
You know who.
Psst, come on.
It's the end of the world as we know it. It's the end of the world as we know it. It's the end of the world as we know it. And I feel fine.
Nice if I could touch your body. I know not everybody has got a body.
tonight, working up a sweat. Let's go show the guys that we know how to become number one in a hot body show. Now push it.
This one goes out to all my love.
My love. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
This one goes out to the one I've left behind.
Yeah, yeah,
yeah. Push it, push it, push it, push it.
I think you know, darling. We're like people, but less expensive.
From New York, New York, the former home of Guy Fieri's American Kitchen and Bar, it's
Show Me What You Got
with your host, Astronautilus.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to another episode of Show Me What You Got. I'm your host, Andy Bothwell, and boy, oh boy, do we have an exciting show for you tonight. We've got a big guest, a real big guest, the rap game Tim the Tool Man Taylor, the most beautiful hair in hip-hop. Give a big Show Me What You Got welcome to Sims from Doomtree Records. Great. You look great, folks. Hey, look at that. Pilates yoga with your teacher. Palm Beach diet. Cookie diet.
That's right, Stro. Couldn't be more pleased to be here. It's a real pleasure, Stro.
The pleasure is all ours. So without any further ado, Sims, show me what you got.
Well, Stro, I have a very special thing near and dear to my heart today. I would like to show you this. This lamp. This is my lamp.
Was that a jaguar?
That's correct, man. This is a black jaguar straight from the jungles of Peru, perhaps, or some other foreign land. Really an artifact, some would say. It's a sort of a dance between life and death. You know, it's the dead skinned animal on top and the beautiful jaguar below kind of admiring its kill.
You're nothing if not a spiritual man, Sims.
Well, what I love most about this item here is it actually belongs to Paper Tiger, and because he asked me to hang on to this before he moved to New York 9 years ago, and I just have.
Paper Tiger, come and take it, my man. Come and take
over it. Over my dead body, Papes.
Out of his cold, dead hands. Ladies and gentlemen, I would love to sit here and pick your brain more about the circle of life and death and the spirit animal that is your lamp, but we are all out of time. That's all the time that we have on Show Me What You Got, so please give a big round of applause for our guests. Give a big round of applause for yourself. Thank you very much. I'm your host, Danny Bothwell, and I'll see you next week on Show Me What You Got.
And you ain't even lit yet. That quality is great. Careful what you take. Only had a little, and he said he need a break. No lie, I'm my own supply. Fuck your stash house. I'm the motherfucking trap house. I ain't a drug, I'm the trap house.
Sure, what a twisty one, the love, sure. Washer need a
What I'm doing, what we doing, what they doing, what they doing, what they doing.
This is working better, right?
Yeah.
I think that's great. Well, it's take two of what they doing.
I'm
a man, you know, sometimes you got to go inward instead of extending outward. So right now I'm checking in with my ultimate man and six.
You go backwards to go forwards.
Yeah. Right. Six Trim Brethren, Paper Tiger, who I'm not sure you realize, your screen name is John Smells. You see that?
That's good enough.
Is your wife?
That's good enough. Yeah, that's good enough. I'll work with that.
I have a cool name. What is the, tell me a funny joke. I know that's the worst question. You got one?
Oh, boy. Good jokes.
Here, I'll start you off.
Okay.
My mom's favorite joke of all time. She loves this one. What is brown and sits on a piano bench?
What?
Beethoven's Last Movement. That's a poop joke.
Yeah.
All right. So I was just teeing you up there.
Here's how I get all of my jokes. Ready?
Yep.
Alexa, tell me a joke about dogs.
I once seen a dog so good at fetching, he was promoted to branch manager.
All right. So the joke is, I once knew a dog that was so good at fetching, he was promoted to branch manager. Right?
What I'm doing, what we doing, what they doing, what they doing, what they doing.
I'm gravitating that way, and take that how you will. But it's mostly just trucker hats when it's not a show of force majeure. Like, I think makeup might be over. I actually do wonder if women are going to dress. Like, I'd forgotten that, like, skinny jeans are super uncomfortable. I knew that when I first put them on, and I've been reminded now that I don't wear pants.
You know what's awesome? You know what's awesome about dudes' pants is there's jeans, and those are uncomfortable, but then there's, like, slacks. And slacks are the greatest trick the devil ever pulled because they're just sweatpants, basically. That, like, I just learned this. Yeah, this is business attire. See these?
Oh, those are great. Put your knee real close to the camera. Like, closer. Yeah. Yes.
Right.
That's a great
pant. That is, it's basically a sweatpant, but it's a business pant. So I can do two birds with one stone. You know, I can show
up. What kind of birds, man? Yes. Yeah, that'll fuck up a bird for sure.
Business. This is auto reply to all emails business. But yes, I think that, and that sounds good. That works for your budget. It's wonderful.
Those market pants.
Thanks, man. Yeah. You know, I'm wearing an H&M special right now. All this H&M.
Is it?
For sale, yeah.
That makes you like Cinderella. Like, it's 72 hours before all that stuff just dissolves off your body.
And I can still only buy things on sale at H&M because I cannot pay full price for anything ever.
Is that true?
Well, for a few things. A few things if they're special to me, like this pair of J's, which I just bought. Now, I paid full retail for these, but this, I repaid $16. It was 41 new, so I had to buy it at 16.
Ooh.
I'm losing money if I don't buy it.
Absolutely. I think you're losing, yeah. I think maybe anyway, we're all losing money. That's just kind of, no matter what the antecedent is.
Episode six, we're all.
Oh, Thunder.
Hot! Cool is all you got!
You know, in this day and age, with the record sales plummeting and skyrocketing gas prices making independently promoted tours prohibitively expensive, why would a group at your level even attempt to release an album and support it on the road?
You know, Chuck, that's a great question, but I just don't have the answer.
I guess it's just for the love of music then, huh?
Absolutely.
Now, you've all been good friends for quite some time, have lived together and worked together, and the whole thing just really reminds me of the classic television program Friends. I've been working it out and assuming that you're the Chandler of the group, Sims, and POS, you're Joey, who would you both cast as Ross?
I'm not exactly sure what you're talking about.
Okay, POS. Brothers and sisters, I have none, but this man's father is my father's son. Who is this man?
I don't know.
Chuck? I lost contact with
music really can move people to action and can change.
This is fascinating, how we can see all these things happen thousands of years, millions of years, billions of years ago. And you stay with us and see it, because this is really interesting. I'm not going to move from this spot. We're going to go. I'll move.
Okay. Now that we're done with our delightful little summer scene, it's time for the final step, the artist's signature.
Hey, yo, Turbo! Turbo, Turbo,
here
Turbo!
Here we go again. Yeah. Alright, alright.
Got hitting the bars tonight.
For the camera. Look at you guys, we got nothing.
Oh, come on, we ain't that bad.
Sweet.
Yeah. Turbo, what up, dude?
Oh, shit.
What the? Oh!
Rumor is, although you are primarily a DJ and producer, you wrote most of the lyrics on the new Doomtree album.
Honestly, it couldn't be further from the truth.
Jesus Christ! Hey, Steve! Can you fix this? I'm sorry. Please continue.
Couldn't be further from the truth. I only wrote Mike's raps.
Most exciting trophy buck adventure ever produced.
Shoot.
I have no idea where we are right now. I'm gonna go.
Here's
gonna, I'm gonna see you tomorrow.
Here you go, alright.
Okay.
Dude, it was weird.
It was late to be. It was fine.
Yesterday we were in the studio laying down some stuff and you know, all day, and I didn't think to mention, I guess maybe I was a little self-conscious. I guess she probably was too, because it never came up.
I don't know why you would do this, and then I guess B, I don't know why you're wasting the film on asking me.
Yeah, I mean, from the get-go, it's just a very strange feeling to knock on the door of someone that you actually know and see quite often. And so that kind of set a bad tone.
I'm not gonna go on another date with Lazy B. No, absolutely, he's lazy.
She did at the end, she said she had my number, so we'll see. You know, maybe I get a call back and not gonna rule anything out ever, because you know, weird things have happened, man.
Brown from Jacksonville, Florida. I'm wondering if the polka shreds.
Polka shreds only when Weird Al does those medleys of all the best songs of the year. Yeah. And makes them into one long polka song where he just does like the verse of this song, the chorus of this song, the verse of this song, but it's all one long polka. That's as close as polka gets to shredding, yeah, as far as I've seen it.
Hard no.
Yeah.
I'm also going to say Weird Al doesn't shred.
Oh, no. Everything Weird Al touches shreds.
Yeah.
Hard.
I knew that was coming.
I'm a Pips.
Big Weird Al fan.
I'm a Pips.
He was just here last night at the State Fair.
Yeah, he's touring.
Yeah. With an orchestra.
It's a whole thing.
With an orchestra.
Really?
Well, I can't wait to release his record on Doomtree. Weird Al. With
Weird Al and the Minnesota Orchestra. Week, this is the first thing that came in.
Yeah,
this is fantastic. I think this is a five-year-old, if I remember right.
Wow,
that's something I would hang on. Look at this. I mean, what is that really? I'd much rather have this.
I agree.
That was a gift, Beak. I'm just saying.
I'll take it. You know what? It's done. I'll take this one.
We'll put Major Biggs' address right here.
Yeah.
Send it on over.
I like it a lot.
No, I love this.
I do like this. It's great.
This kid's got a future.
Unlike
I got to be honest with you guys.
We all do.
Well, I hope so. I never really messed with green as a color most of my life, and later in my life, I'm coming around to it. I'm digging some dark, as you can see clearly by the wall color. I'm digging some
dark. Maybe three green things that you like.
Three green things that I like?
Yep, absolutely.
Wow. I actually can't think of any right now.
Okay. That's okay. We're coming around to it. We're coming around to it.
Come on, we'll come back to it. If it pops up in my head, I'll let you know. More of a blue and a purple guy, really. You know what I'm saying? All right.
So you can't name three.
All right, so that's the last one.
Do we actually cucumbers. Cucumbers.
Okay.
Cucumbers.
I like cucumbers. Limes. All right. And
four-leaf clovers.
Yeah, I don't know. Grass.
That's amazing.
There you go.
Yep.
There you go.
There you go.
Yep.
Grass.
I'm a color guy. I don't see color, guys. I don't really see color, you know?
I get it. No problem. No problem.
Yep.
Simsy Fixy Forever, episode 5. Welcome back, everybody. How you doing this week, babies? Another weird week. Thank you all so much for all the comments, suggestions, shout-outs, tributes, the various contributions to the Simsy Fixy verse that we're all building simultaneously. This week, a lot of stories about the potential of a parallel universe where things run backwards. And I would argue that we're already there, baby. 2020 is weird. So I've been thinking a lot about time, and it's elusive, and I don't have enough of it, and it doesn't feel real anymore. It's kind of starting to feel like money or something else. I'm not quite exactly sure what I'm feeling this week. So what I am feeling this week is whatever I can contribute to making your space gorgeous and marvelous. That's exactly what I want to be doing. So I'm going to contribute some of my time this week to give you some inspiration to make your space beautiful. We're going to do a quick one. It's going to be fast. It's going to be very easy. Caulk area that gets disgusting, mildewy, cracked, whatever. I happen to have had a crappy one for many years in my house and don't fix it because it's time. But this week, hopefully I inspire you to, you know, show you how fast things can get done if you just put your heart into it, okay? Okay, let's do it. Episode 5, let's go. Back once again in the upstairs bath of the Simsy Fixy Mansion Manor. All we need this week, really simple. We need just simply a razor blade, putty knife, some silicone. These are different varieties. It could be any of these all-purpose or bathroom related. You need a caulk gun. You need an old t-shirt. You know, it's a shame to let this In-N-Out t-shirt go, but it's no longer John Blazin. It's maybe John Raisin. I'm terrible with this stuff. So we're just gonna rip it out of there and then put some new stuff in, really easy. This right here, if you're wondering what this is just a little board and I routed a little slot for the iPads. You know, you can luxuriate in the bathtub. I can show you how to do that some other time, but we're gonna get that out of the way, take this caulking out, put some new one in, here we go. All right, now, as we can see, some really big gaps here. Really a lot of junk. In a perfect world, we would pull this out and then put some grout down and then put some silicone caulking on. But
I don't know what about 2020 makes you assume that this world is perfect. So we're just going to do it with the time we have. We're just going to rip it out, put some new silicone in. We'll probably have to fix it in 2-3 years, but it's going to work for now. Because who knows?
Okay, here you go. Start by just cutting the caulking along the tile. Do this gently so you don't scratch your tile or scratch your tub. Both sides, like so. And then take your putty knife and just kind of gently work it out of there. There we go, it should just pull right off like that. Left with this big old nasty chunk. All right, now that you've got your caulk away, we'll just clean the section up a little bit. Take the edge of the putty knife right here. You wet down that old t-shirt you had. Remove any of the kind of debris. Then you take a caulk gun and run a little bead right down, like this. If you get a little bit of excess, that's okay. We'll be wiping it down to make a nice smooth line in a second here. This is really easy, you guys. You're doing a great job. You guys are champions. Heroes, really. Now this is the point at which you use your brand new faucet that y'all did this week. Wet that t-shirt down a little bit. Now don't be afraid to get rid of that old Taylor Swift t-shirt that you've been hanging on too long. You know, that band you used to love a lot, Doomtree maybe. And then you just grab it. I like to put my little index finger in like that, bow, and then just kind of run it right along the edge. Take the excess, I just fold it in like that, and then just kind of gently smooth it, and you can see what's left. Look at that. Nice little bead left behind. And go one more quick light pass over. And I make sure to get really fine in here against the tub so you don't have an excess against the tub. So here we are, looking pretty nice, looking pretty lovely. I like to do that part with the tub empty so I can just kind of lean into it, get big bodied in there. But a very helpful tip, and this came from, shout out my homie Bethany from Bethy Duzzy. Fill the tub up now with water, and what that's going to do is when this dries, it's going to be at full weight, so at full, the full stretch out that the tub is going to make. So keep that in there, keep the water in there for a few hours while this caulking sets. Maybe you want to get your little melatonin sleep soak in at the same time. And have a very luxurious week, you guys. Enjoy your beautiful new bath. Don't forget to fill it with water. Don't forget to fill your soul with joy. Be easy on yourself. Have a good one.
Oh, go.
All right. I just want to talk about something really serious for a change. Just forget all the silly filters and, you know, all the jokes aside.
Honey, the filter's still on.
Well, how do you turn it off?
Never doubt options offered, often toss them to the chop and block them, hostile dodge them. Keep watch, but I've been rocking. Whole team got a grip, got it. No polish.
Doomtree, bang-a-rang. All these rappers sound the same. Beats sound the same. Raps sound the same. Wings fan the flame. Teeth with the fangs. 10 years in our lane. Doomtree, bang-a-rang.
Now underneath this canopy, crumbling insanity. These bellies rumbling, hungering for the fantasy. Had to see something come from them, had to be crushing savagely.
Not
your average every day,
nothing short of a masterpiece.
And the tortures of the past are like a fortune for the future. We've been fortunate enough to know no borders,
no rules.
No schools are out of session, no schools out of the question. No tools will go unused,
and no fools will go unmentioned.
And there's a tension in the air we're breathing. We breathe heavy, we breathe largely. Release the levy, feel the tension in the air we're breathing, and breathe heavy, and breathe largely. Release the levy like
Doomtree, bang-a-rang. All these rappers sound the same.
Beats
sound the same.
Raps
sound the same.
Wings
fan the flame.
Teeth
with the fangs. 10 years in our lane. Doomtree, bang-a-rang. Doomtree, bang-a-rang.
All these rappers sound the same.
Beats sound the same.
Raps
sound the same.
Wings
fan the flame.
Teeth
with the fangs.
10 years in our lane.
Doomtree, bang-a-rang.
They hate, they pity, they say we too heady, too heavy, too many, too much punk, much too drunk, too much luck, love too much.
Yup.
But earn it all. All work till the curtain calls and the time is up. They got enough. And it burns them up. Before tour and first stab, it was D4 at the T-Rock. Toki Bite, big shocker. Made more than a name drop. But I got y'all when I see y'all. And I keep y'all when the beat stops. I build more than a rap career.
I got my family here.
Some punks wanna jump up with a sharp tongue and they fronts up. That we got here by dumb luck. But they just wanna become us. That's what's up when you come up. I move like a dump truck. Too long in the road and I earn what I hold. Even wanna let me know, I could burn your flow like
whoa.
Come on, buddy.
Doomtree, bang-a-rang. All these rappers sound the same. Beats sound the same.
Raps
sound the same.
Wings
fan the flame.
Teeth
with the fangs. 10 years in our lane. Doomtree, bang-a-rang.
Doomtree, bang-a-rang.
All these rappers sound the same.
Beats
sound the same.
Raps
sound the same.
Wings
fan the flame.
Teeth
with the fangs.
10 years in our lane.
Doomtree, bang-a-rang.
Doomtree,
bang-a-rang.
Doomtree,
bang-a-rang. 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 Bang-a-rang.
Doomtree,
bang-a-rang.
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 Bang-a-rang. Bang-a-rang.
Yeah, it was the end of the song. You left me hanging there.
Bang-a-rang.
Yeah, we did it, y'all.
Did it twice.
Parallel universe?
But the original stories were from NASA. This was legitimately news. This wasn't nonsense.
It was on like heavy.com and the New York Post. So,
right.
Being like Mashable. These aren't really like, it's not the Atlantic or something.
Yeah.
Reporting this.
Yeah.
It's sort of internet.
Yeah. But that's like one of those unprovable theories anyway, like, right? Like there's a neighboring universe that works upside down that we can't access. Okay. You know what I mean? It's like, there's no way to test that idea. Right? Okay. Let's see whose hair is getting, I feel like I'm gonna be honest. I think I'm going to catch you.
Getting longer?
I'm coming for you.
Mine has hit, look at this. That's pretty long. Mine has hit the back of my shoulder.
That's exciting. Can you feel it when you, whoa.
I know.
Can you feel it when you're just standing?
Yeah. And it goes, when I put a shirt on, I have to pull it out from under the shirt now.
Yeah. There should be a name for that.
That's luxurious, I think is the name for it.
I think they call it
glamour.
Maybe. Today was my first pigtail day. I did the full, you know what I mean? You got to figure out a way to not have it, you know?
Yeah. Well, you know what I do is I keep this little chip clip on hand.
You know what's funny is that you inspired me. Yeah, absolutely.
This is what I do. What I do usually when no one's around, because I don't even go outside of the house with this on, but I'll do it on Doomtree.
Really?
Yeah. Okay. Well, because this is not really the look I was hoping to achieve in my life. But
let me see if I can do it too. So just right on top, one big swirl.
I just kind of, and then flip it so it's not in my face. And then I just
auto-reply
emails all afternoon. So if you're getting an email from me, just picture me like.
Sure, but in slacks.
Yeah, in this, basically in this outfit. With
is this right? Okay. This is right.
Pretty good, yeah.
It's cool.
Twirl it up. It's like a pasta. Twirl it.
It's like a pasta.
With the pasta tongs. My hair is pasta.
It's a brunette fettuccine. That's my new rap name.
It's a fettuccine.
Brunette fettuccine.
All right. It would be week 3, week 6, week 9. Time is a flat circle. Thank you all so much for joining us again. Yessa, what do you want to leave them with? Thanks to the Doomtree Patreons, all of you guys
for
supporting what we do and keeping new projects rolling, keeping all the weird stuff we're up to in business and keeping the lights on over here. We appreciate you tons.
And being patient and kind to one another too. Like, yeah, just, I don't know. There's been some really sweet little moments I've seen on the street. And even when you don't know, no one's watching, it counts. It counts.
No doubt about it. And I just want to, again, reapply that to yourself, to being patient and kind to yourself this next week. Will be a big deal for all of us. Like our challenge for week 7 is to be patient and kind with ourselves and give ourselves a little bit of margin to be humans and make mistakes and all that. So that's it. Love y'all.
Hey, next week.
Look at that.
Look at that. Can we just? That's cool.
I am in charge, capable, determined, resilient, unstoppable.